Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the University of Manchester, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the School of Materials graduation ceremony in the splendid surroundings of the Whitworth Hall. In particular, I would like to welcome your families and friends who are sharing this special occasion with you. I know the immense sense of pride that your family members must feel as they see you graduate. I am sure that all of you graduating today will recognize the huge role that your family and friends have played in your success. It's not only the financial investment that they have made, but the support that I am sure that you will have received when you thought you would never complete your degree, the late night calls, the constant encouragement, the shoulder to cry on. It is therefore right that we, as the university, also acknowledge the role that you, our guests today, have played in the success of your friends and family members. We honor you because the students that are graduating today are doing so because of the dedication and investment of others like you. So in order to acknowledge the role that your families and friends have played in your success, I want you to stand, face your guests up there as well, make eye contact, and give a special thank you to them. Will you stand and thank you? Okay, sit down. I'll now address my comments to you. Even though many of you are leaving, this will remain your institution. We refer to the university community as alma mater because this is where we hope that you have developed your sense of humanity and when you have become part of a community. You have become who you are because of your community. So we hope that graduating does not end your relationship with us. At the end of this ceremony, you will join a new community of more than 250,000 University of Manchester graduates living and working across the globe. Networks such as this become even more important at times like this. So make a special effort to join and play an active part. The Alumni Association will help you to remain in contact with the university and with each other through reunions, networking opportunities, the Alumni Magazine, and the internet. Our alumni also play a vital role in supporting some of our students. Some of you may have worked with students who have come to study here as part of our equity and merit scholarships, reserved for a group of very able students from Uganda, Rwanda, and Bangladesh, who would not have had the opportunity or the resources to benefit from a Manchester education. And they've come here so they can make a difference to their own societies through studying and learning in Manchester. It is a program that we take great pride in because it underlies our belief that education and work are the levers to lift up a people. As graduates from the Faculty of Engineering and Physical Sciences in the University of Manchester, you are in an extremely privileged position, and your achievement in completing your qualification should not be underestimated. Simply by arriving to study in Manchester, you set yourselves apart. Only 40% of young people in this country have the opportunity to go to university. Graduating from one of the top universities in this country and from an institution that is rapidly rising up the ranks to become one of the top universities in the world, you will become part of a global elite that sets you apart from your peers. But of course, with privilege should come responsibility. It is not so much about what you have learned that will distinguish you from your peers, but how you apply what you have learned. It is about what you do with what you have learned. A university education should be a transforming experience where I hope you have been encouraged to confront your own personal beliefs, values, assumptions, expectations, hopes, and fears. We hope that we have helped you develop global perspectives and encourage you to reflect on wider social and environmental issues. But it is not just about achievement in the traditional sense that is important. We come to universities not only to further our careers, but to become citizens. And in order to make good citizens, our responsibility as your teachers has been to educate people capable of building just, humane, and sustainable human communities on a small and exceedingly dangerous planet. Knowledge, wisdom, and humanity, to translate the Latin motto of the university, is what we have tried to impart. Our founding statement, when we created the new university in October 2004, stated that we wanted to make our university a place where students, whatever their backgrounds, learn to pursue truth through rational inquiry, where researchers engaged in discovery are also teachers, where research is valued both for its own sake and for the betterment of the world, where academic freedom is encouraged and protected, where the cultivation of cognitive skills, independence of mind, intellectual integrity, and artistic expression promotes understanding and appreciation of the best that is known, thought, and created in the world, and where students and staff are encouraged, as responsible citizens of their own societies and of the international community, to embrace fundamental human and civil rights as the only just, sustainable basis for a humane civilization. That is a challenge that we now set to you, to use the knowledge that you have gained not only for your own and your family's achievement, but for the betterment of society, for tolerance and understanding. Education is what will help us to innovate, to challenge bigotry, and to embrace fundamental human and civil rights and meet the challenges of the future. It is the graduates of universities like Manchester that have the potential to ask the questions and seek explanations for how we arrived in these turbulent times and how we can transform them. The skills that you have learned can begin to address some of the major challenges that we now face. This ceremony has been repeated in much the same way in this hall for over 100 years. I myself do not understand the significance of all the bowing and doffing of hats, the standard bearers of procession. But the essence of what the ceremony conveys is our independence, our role not as a bureaucracy or a government agency or a social service agency, but our job to train, to educate, and to question. John Masefield, the poet laureate from 1930 to 1967, was so enamored by universities that he wrote, "There are few earthly things more beautiful. It is a place where those who hate ignorance may strive to know, where those who perceive truth may strive to make others see, where seekers and learners alike, banded together in the search for knowledge, will honor thought in all its finer ways, will welcome thinkers in distress or in exile, will uphold ever the dignity of thought and learning, and will exact standards in these things." George Bernard Shaw has frequently been misquoted and rarely acknowledged as the originator of these words that I want to leave you with. They sum up beautifully the challenge for you and how you can use your privileged education. Let me paraphrase. "Most people look at things as they are and wonder why. We should dream of things that never were and ask, why not?" So on behalf of the university, I congratulate all of you who are graduating here today on your academic and professional achievements, and I wish you every success in your future careers. Thank you very much. I'll now ask Professor Robert Young to say a few words about your school.
Thank you. On behalf of the School of Materials, I'd like to welcome you all here to the annual summer degree ceremony, where we award both postgraduate and undergraduate degrees at the same time. Now, the School of Materials is by far the largest and most comprehensive university department of its type in the country, in Europe, and probably in the whole of the Western world. We have a very wide range of activities in areas that include textiles, metals, ceramics, polymers, composites, biomedical materials, nanotechnology. I'm Robert Young. I'm former head of the school. I was actually the founding head of the school. And I'm standing in for Professor Paul O'Brien, who sends his apologies. He's been called away on an urgent university business involving a major research initiative with a multinational company, which will hopefully be announced shortly. Now, the ceremony, of course, is taking place in these grand surroundings of the Whitworth Hall. And it's very appropriate to do it in here because we can do it in the presence of our friends and families. And I know we've all shown our gratitude to them already. And the contributions of friends and families is becoming increasingly more important as we have both academic and financial pressures. If I now turn to the graduands, At the front, we have the doctoral graduates who spent the last 3 or 4 years undertaking research at the cutting edge and writing their theses. They've also been involved in producing research papers, giving lectures at international conferences and seminars, a very important training for a life in research. The research in the school is at the forefront of knowledge, and one aspect of our research is it's taken in close collaboration with major companies and large industrial organizations. We work particularly closely with aerospace, oil and gas, nuclear industries. We have major initiatives in composites manufacturing, light alloys, nuclear manufacturing, and graphene engineering. And the university has recently invested £9 million into a beamline at the Diamond Synchrotron at Harwell in Oxfordshire, which the school is taking a leading role in. Most of our graduates today, however, are undergraduates who've been studying our three and four year programs in a wide range of subjects such as material science and engineering, biomedical material science, textiles and fashion, design, retailing, management, marketing, and technology. The academic staff you see on my left have all been involved in delivering these programs, and it's been a very rewarding experience for them and a pleasure to teach you. A number of undergraduates on our programs have also had a chance to spend a year in industry or commerce as part of their degree programs. And this has given them invaluable experience and established important links for the future. Now, as materials graduates, you're all poised to go into the world to make your mark. And knowing what talented people you are, I'm confident you'll be successful in whatever ventures you undertake. We know that employers favor graduates from Manchester University, and the subjects we teach in the School of Materials are extremely relevant to our national needs. At lunchtime, I awarded a series of prizes for students who had had exceptional performances in these programs. But now it's the time for all of you to receive your own personal prize, your degree certificate. Now, even the weather in Manchester has been kind to us this afternoon, and I hope it will not, you'll be able to go on now after the ceremony to have your celebrations, and they won't be dampened anymore. So thank you very much, and congratulations to everybody. Vice President, on behalf of the Senate of the University, I present to you for the degree of Doctorate of Philosophy, Ismaila Idowu Ahmed. Alphonse Anadraja Antanisami. Julia Doff. James Michael Duggan. Paul Edward Hunt. Kayoko Kawano. Lorraine McDermott. Gideon Chima Abasi. Mohammed Mohammed M. Ayareth. Reese William Rhodes. Tahir Sharif. Leslie Ann Turner. Margaret Wesgren. Jian Fai Wei. Soraya Jabin. And for the degree of Doctor of Enterprise, Sarah Joanne Lally. And for the degree of Doctor of Engineering, Nicholas Wright. Robert Hurlston. And for the degree of Master of Science by Research in Advanced Materials Aerospace Engineering, Jayasundra Mysuram Thaming Hemanga Jayasundra. And for the degree of Master of Science in Advanced Materials Engineering, Hanlin Gu. And for the degree of Master of Engineering in Biomedical Material Science with Honours, Christopher Stanley Storer. And in Biomedical Material Science with Industrial Experience with Honours, Alifuolafami Ajijime J. Risham Amjad. Thomas Lane. Daniel Joseph Mason. Akshita Patil. Ibirange Satande Peters. And in Material Science and Engineering with Honours, Xijing Chen. Xifang Liu. Pan Liu. Tat Leung Swen. Zhen Ji. Li Zhang. Wen Xuan Zhang. And in Material Science and Engineering with Industrial Experience with Honours, Afaya Hope Chaholo. Jack Marsden Donahue. Eric Lap Chun Kwok. Hawei Ma. Giovanni Afedu. And for the degree of Bachelor of Science, Biomedical Material Science, with honors, Fraz Ahmed. Rayomand Bandarawala. Candice Bellis. Modinat Liadi. Melody Obeng. Yannick Tobias Onifade. Tulsi Patel. Miraj Patel. Maria Saeed. Jennifer Spiller. Bernadette Santugu. Adam Philip Strange. Finella Tancred Holmes. Joseph Zigoya. And in design management for fashion retailing with honors, Sophie Allen. Chloe June Allen. May Badran. Natasha Sari Bell. Cherry Anna Brealey. Imogen Curtis. Jessica Farika. Sarah Galley. Justine Gibbons. Alice Grinstead. Molly Harvey Love. Francis Hussey. Catherine Alice James Lowry. Chantelle Andrea Macmillan Kerrigan. Sarah Jane Leeming. Emily Lisa. Han Lee. Natasha Bianca Eileen Lindley. Victoria Mason. Charlotte Mills. Alexandra Reeder. Eniola Tamara Sokoya. Stephanie Hannah Steer. Natasha Rose Studdart. Jade Turner. Sarah Weatherly. Pian Pian Wu. Yishong Jiang. Yanwen Zhu. Joanna Zamuda. And in design management for fashion retailing with industrial experience with honors, Alice James Holmes. Caroline Molina Johnson. Bryony Pestel. Eleanor Mary Louise West. Kaylee Louise Webster Young. Anna Katie Foster. Eleanor Jane Linton. Noreen Nanji. Natalie Sedgley. Sarah Elizabeth Smith. Kate Daisy Stevens. And in fashion and textile retailing with honors, Sophie Elizabeth Adams. Sophie Rebecca Airy. Jessica Aston. Sarah Elizabeth Birch. Romy Blangner. Natalie Brown. Rebecca Brown. Charlotte Burton. Rachel Chan. Ruby Chan. Jeslyn Lai Yin Chan. Lin Chen. Roshni Chugani. Anna Climo. Stephanie Emma May Crockford. Leonie Beth Dean. Lucy Demetrio. Faye Edwards. Omar Foster Shah. Sumra Gabriel. Suzanne Goodall. Zoe Rebecca Harrison. Felicity Hellard. Tara Jenny Hill. Haley Humphreys. Isabel Hunter. Pernell Fajar Jacobson. Sean Ahmad Jadoon. Lucy Jamieson. Rhiannon Jenkins. William Jones. Jason Lee. Jiao Liang. Kirsty Lum. Rosaline Violet McCauley. Lauren Grace Malone. Sarah Marfleet. Rosalind Sarah Mays. Nina Mertahiri. Aofi Mulligan. Hang Nguyen. Juaro Niu. Sasha Naranja. Clemency Blaze Pierce. Rachel Phillips. Ellen Margaret Pipkin. Hannah Richards. Harriet Anastasia Scaramanga. Stephanie Kate Shaw. Sandra Ching Wen Wang. Bethany Watts. Hiruku Wickramasinghe. Samantha Jocelyn Wijara. Laura Jade Wilson. And in fashion and textile retailing with industrial experience with honours, Elizabeth Dean. Eleanor Hopkins. Jacqueline Howard. Tessa Mary Ruth Maxwell. Jasmine Camilla Murphy. Sylvia Keng San Kwek. Emily Sarah Rowley. Fiona Sorga. Millie Wildgoose. And in fashion and textile retailing with study abroad with honours, Madeline Suzanne Chapman. Felicia Spenson. And in management and marketing of textiles with honours, Chandra Alawani. Louisa Audrey Emma Brown. Sophie May Dearden. Laura Gale. Abigail Rose Gretsch. Anna Higgins. Yi Hu. Jacqueline Janssen. Kimberly Jane Jackson. Cheng Liu. Haoji Liu. Xuan Qi Liu. Jun Ya Lu. Laura Philpott. Harisastivel Radna Krishnan. Jessica Rifat. Alia Sukaina Rizvi. Natasha Rebecca Sigal Cantor. Keijian Shi. Mengjia Shi. Tessa Smith. Xiaoyi Tao. Chen Tao. Yashu Wang, Myra Wazim, Flora Weber, Mark David Wolf, Kei Yang, Binbin Zhang, Lai Zhao, Xichong Zhao, Lin Zhuo. And in management and marketing of textiles with industrial experience with honors, Lucy Allett Stewart Johnson. Leanne Jane Wilkinson. Emily Wong. And in material science and engineering with honors, Amina Habiba Ahmed. Robert Chan. Yi Hua. Ashley Naranha. Muhammad Adil Sheikh. Yeah! And in textile design and design management with honors, Roxanne Anton Yu. Haley Celine Ashurst. Jiachi Chen. Philippa Inga Frost. Anusha Francesca Jarashid Najad. Nicola Gillard. Sophia Kay. Trishna Kilosia. Joanna Christina Klepka. Josephine McNamara. Alice Martin. Anna Marie Maynard. Sita Mara. Emily Rickson. Ami Sibic. Helen Torpy. Rebecca Williamson. And in textile design and design management with industrial experience with honors, Victoria Louise Lavery. Abby Grace Simmons. Laura and Kathleen Watson. And in textile science and technology with honors, Chi Hang Poon. Oluwadamulu Temitope Smith. Elizabeth Snape. Renwai Tian. Tian Tong. And in textile technology business management with honors, Mohammed Mardini. Anirud Pankaj Thakur. Lucy Young. And in biomedical material science, Andrew Barcelon. Christabel Gondway. Wakako Hazaki. Ai Jiang. And for the award of certificate of Higher Education, Fashion and Textile Retailing, Seda Parseka. And in Fashion and Textile Retailing with honors, Pen Fang. And in management and marketing of textiles with honors, Ran Zhu.
On behalf of the university, I once again congratulate all of you who are graduating here today on your excellent achievements, and I wish you every success and happiness in your future lives and careers. I now declare the ceremony closed. Please stand.